to me thus: Before I formed you in the womb, I knew. Before you were born, I dedicated you. A prophet to the nations, I appointed you. Ah, Lord God, I said, I do not know how to speak. I am too young. But the Lord answered me, Say not, I am too young. To whoever I send you, you shall go. Whatever I command you, you shall speak. Have no fear before them, because I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord. Then the Lord extended his hand and touched my mouth, saying, See, I place my words in your mouth. The word of the Lord.
Persevere in both tasks. by doing so, you will save both yourself and those who listen to me. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus, raise your eyes to heaven and pray, saying, Holy Father, I reveal your name to those whom you gave me out of the world. They belong to you, and you gave them to me, and they have kept your word. I gave them your word, and the world hated them, because they did not belong to the world any more than I.
Those who to be ordained priests, come forward.
Present. Most Reverend Father, Holy Mother Church, ask you to ordain Zane, our brother, to the responsibility of priesthood.
dear friends in Christ, I welcome all of you across the diocese and many points of the Cathedral of Our Lady. This is a joyous night, this evening in this gathering for this special occasion for our diocese, this moment of grief for all of us. This has been 4 years in waiting for me. It has been a long time since we've done one of these, and so it was with great joy that we gathered tonight. You know, I would like to extend a special welcome to Deacon Zane's family, in particular to you, Steve, and Ina. It's because of your faith, because of your love for the church, that your son now stands before us tonight, answering the Lord's call to priesthood. Israel, our vocations, they don't come out of nowhere, but they're a result of parents and families supporting and encouraging their children to consider such a vocation. So thank you for sharing your son with us and for supporting him in answering the Lord's call to serve God in the diocese of Redwood City as the priest of Jesus Christ. I would also wish to acknowledge a few other special guests who have joined us for this special occasion. Most Reverend John Nguyen, Bishop of the Diocese of Winona, who is one of Deacon Zane's professors. Also representing St. Paul Seminary, ministry will bear fruit only to the extent that your life is rooted in this intimate relationship. planted many gifts in you which have come alive. I've seen them come alive over the years since I've been here. And then he's developed into making who we are today. And saying you have many gifts. And I think in some way we might even use a bullwhip to preach the gospel. That's a gift. You cannot let that go by the wayside. You might lead many people to conversion through that very instrument. And I'm sure there's other things that you've learned on the ranch that you can bring with you as well. But as your priestly ministry begins, my encouragement to you is to be yourself. Just be yourself. Put all those gifts in the service of the Holy Spirit. And the trust that the Lord will use them in ways, that you cannot imagine. As Christ was sent into the world by his Father, now you are being sent into the world, consecrated in truth, in his truth. In being raised in the order of the priesthood, you will exercise that sacred duty of teaching in the name of Christ, the teacher. So meditating on the sacred scriptures, see that you believe what you read, that you teach what you believe, and most importantly, that you practice what you teach. In this way, let what you teach be nourishment for the people of God. Let the holiness of your own life be a delightful fragrance to Christ faithful, so that by word and example, you may help besides being a man of prayer, modeling the one who has called you, be a man of sacrifice. Through your own sacrifice, you will continue the sanctifying work of Jesus Christ. Through your ministry, the spiritual sacrifice of the faithful is made perfect because it is joined to Christ's sacrifice, which in the name of the whole church is offered by your hands in an unbloody way on the altar of the celebration of the sacred mysteries. Be attentive in the celebration of the Eucharist. Understand, therefore, what you do. Imitate what you celebrate, because through taking part in the mystery of the Lord's death and resurrection, you bear Christ's death. So strive to put to death in you all that is not Christ, and walk with him in the newness of life. You know, the Lord Jesus came freely to save us. He himself has said to us, give freely what you receive freely. The celebration of the Eucharist is the summit of the Lord's generosity. So again, imitate his generosity. You know, the secret of true priestly generosity is found in our love for God, lived without limits. Lived without limits is a constant response to the love manifested by Christ crucified. So my dear son, in being raised to the order of priesthood, you will exercise the sacred duty of teaching in the name of Christ, the teacher, as well as his office. Be a faithful steward of the mysteries that Christ is entrusting to you, to your care. And remember, when you gather others into the Paschal mystery, to the sacrament of baptism, when you share mercy and forgiveness in the name of Christ and the Church and the sacrament of penance, when you comfort the sick with holy oil, assisting them in uniting themselves with Jesus' cross, when you celebrate the other sacred rites, remember that Christ is taking you from among the people of God and appointed on their behalf for their sanctification. Therefore, carry out this beautiful mystery of Christ with constant joy and genuine love, attending not only to your own concerns, but to those of Jesus Christ, because it is said that Christ sacrificed. That's what priesthood is all about, sharing. good shepherd gets to know his sheep and is not afraid to go out to the peripheries, as Pope Francis advises us all. A good shepherd is always mindful of the poor and the marginalized. He seeks to save what was lost, seeing in each one of them the face of Christ himself. Always have before your eyes the example of the good shepherd, who did not come to be served, but to serve. Taking part in the mission of Christ the Head Shepherd in filial communion with your bishop, commit yourself to unite the faithful into one path. Here is the closeness of the proper of the priest. Close to God in prayer. Close to the bishop, who is your father. Close to your presbyterates. Close to other priests, his brothers, and close to the So in the name of Christ and his church, saying we need you to be a good, holy, and faithful priest. And I know in my heart of hearts that's what you seek to be. So despite your unworthiness, speak to the world the word of God. Point the world to eternal life. And in your life and ministry, remind us always of the majesty God's grace, the majesty of God's power, the majesty of God's love. My dear friends, this young man sitting before us today has been supported and prayed for by all of us over these years. I would ask you to continue to love him and support him. Finally, may Mary, our mother, our lady of perpetual help, the mother of priests, lead us to the glory of her Son, and help us all to find strength, hope, and courage in him. May God bless all of you. Dear Son, before you enter the order of priesthood, you must declare before the people your intention to undertake this office. So do you resolve, with the help of the Holy Spirit, to discharge without fail the office of priesthood in the episcopal rank as a worthy fellow worker with the order of bishops in caring for the Lord's body? I do. You resolve to exercise the ministry of the word worthily and wisely, preaching the gospel and teaching the Catholic faith. I do. You resolve to celebrate faithfully and reverently, in accord with the Church's tradition, the mysteries of Christ, especially the sacrifice of the Eucharist and the sacrament of reconciliation, for the glory of God and the sanctification of the Christian people. I do. You resolve to implore with us God's mercy upon the people entrusted to your care by observing the command to pray without ceasing. I do. You resolve to be united more closely every day to Christ the High Priest, who offered himself for us to the Father as a pure sacrifice, and with him to consecrate yourself to
Deacon Zane, do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors?
I do.
May God who's begun the good work for you bring it to fulfillment.
My dear
Hear us, we beseech you, Lord, our God, and pour out on the servant of yours the blessing of the Holy Spirit and the power of increasing grace. That this man, in the sight of your mercy, be offered to be consecrated, may be surrounded by your rich and unfailing gifts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So also upon the sons of Mary, who were in abundant share of their father's ministry. That the number of the priests prescribed by the law may be sufficient for the sacrifices of the tabernacle, which were a shadow of the good things to come. But in these last days, Holy Father, you sent your Son into the world, Jesus, who is apostle and high priest of our confession. Through the Holy Spirit, he offered himself to you as a spouse. Receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you do, imitate what you celebrate, and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord Jesus. Be seated.
They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with the word, and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they give up their lives for you, and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself, and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in their salvation we obey.
Communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious Ever Virgin Mary, Mother of God, our Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Linus, Cletus, Simon and Jude, Clement and Sixtus, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray graciously accept this oblation of our service, that it will come. We're our base, in your peace, and that we be delivered by, delivered from eternal damnation, be counted among the flock you have chosen. And therefore, Lord, we pray graciously accept this oblation of our service at your command, which we make to you also for your service, whom you have been pleased to raise to the order of priesthood. And in your mercy, keep sacred gifts in heaven, so that what he has received by divine permission, he may be filled with divine assistance. this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this.
To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints, admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, mighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Thank you.
God.